Joining me now in a first on CNBC interview, David Brain, CEO of Entertainment Properties Trust. Mr. Brain, nice to have you on the program.
Thank you, Maria. Great to be here.
So you reported the first drop in quarterly income in 12 years. Where did you see the slowdown, and how would you characterize business right now?
Well, the slowdown certainly isn't with our theaters and our entertainment in-place assets. I'll tell you that. They're doing very, very well. The really slowdown came to us because we had to stop recognizing some income on some in-development projects. And that's just really because the financing world and the accounting world and the skepticism that's out there makes us stop recognizing this income. We still feel like the projects are good, they're underway, and we'll be money good on those. But that lack of recognition, consistent with last year where we were recognizing income, brought us down. And that was a disappointment, but we'll make it up, I think, in time as these things come online. But the core of our investments, the theaters particularly, which is more than 50% of our investments, and the other things are all functioning very, very well. They're actually ascending fundamentals in our portfolio in this time of otherwise tough sledding in retail.
So tell me more about that. Movie theaters making up the largest portion of that portfolio. What are you seeing in terms of movie theaters? You think people are going to the movies more today than in the past 5 years or so?
Oh, they absolutely are. Attendance is up, for sure. More people are going more often, so it's a broader and it's a more repetitious. People are finding it. It's a way that they want to spend their time. It's a way to get value for their dollar, for their time, and to get away maybe from what otherwise might be the less than, you know, thrilling news that that's about. So, but that's good product, too. I think there's some good product that's been coming out. And the great thing is, Maria, it's not been one film or two films or one or two weekends. It's been very systematic across the calendar so far, really since the holidays. During the holiday period, people were in a little bit of shock. But it's really been coming on very well throughout the year.
Well, it's the cheapest form of entertainment, right?
Yes, it is.
Let me ask you about the credit markets. Do you see any easing there? Have you tried to access the markets? Are you seeing a tight situation still, which is, of course, one of the main issues with this economy?
It certainly is. It's been the main issue with us, and it has eased a little. We are seeing a little better. We are out with our line of credit, re-soliciting a renewal of that that otherwise will expire in 2010. We've only got it a little less than half drawn, so we're in a good position on it. And we've got really a lot of financial institutions in the bank community, the money center banks, would hardly be able to talk in Q3 and Q4 of 08. And now we're having very good dialogue and progressing on that. So we are seeing a little bit more movement in the credit market. And yes, otherwise, we'll be thinking about some long-term financing placement on some of our assets, these that are under construction and coming online.
Because you've got to roll that over. You still don't have the commitments, though, in terms of those rollovers.
That's right. That's still very difficult, particularly when you get to a project that's $100 million or more and you're talking about a large-size loan. It's maybe the loans, you know, maybe we have a $200 million project. Really, even at 50% loan value, at $100 million, though, there's still a stumbling block for a lot of institutions. That part of the market and the very large size is still very difficult.
Very interesting. Very interesting to hear your take, really, on the front lines of this issue. David, nice to have you on the program. Thank you.
Thank you, Maria. Enjoyed it very much.
We'll see you on the movies.